My brothers and sisters, may the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jacob was the father of Joseph, the husband of Mary. Of her was born Jesus, who is called the Christ. Now this is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took his wife into his home. The Gospel of the Lord. We celebrate today the feast of St. Joseph, who is patron of this cathedral and of this diocese, and also patron of a happy death. And although I was very young at the time, I can recall my mother telling me about the story of my great-grandmother, whose husband had had a very long, because of sickness, very long and painful death. She used to pray that she'd have a peaceful death, not much more for the sake of her daughter, my grandmother, as opposed to herself. And she had popcorn the night before the Feast of St. Joseph and went to bed, and a little bit after midnight, quietly went to peace and to the Lord. So I always remember that story about her. Today, St. Bernard of Siena offers us, specifically in the Office of Readings, a little reflection on the significance and meaning of St. Joseph. There is a general rule concerning all special graces granted to any human being. Whenever the divine favor chooses someone to receive a special grace or to accept a lofty vocation, God adorns the person chosen with all the gifts of the Spirit needed to fulfill the task at hand. This general rule is especially verified in the case of St. Joseph, the foster father of our Lord and the husband of the Queen of our world, enthroned above the angels. He was chosen by the Eternal Father as the trustworthy guardian and protector of his greatest treasures, namely his divine son and Mary, Joseph's wife. He carried out this vocation with complete fidelity until at last God called him, saying, "Good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of your Lord." What then is Joseph's position in the whole Church of Christ? Is he not a man chosen and set apart? Through him, and yes, under him, Christ was fittingly and honorably introduced into the world. Holy Church in its entirety is indebted to the Virgin Mother because through her it was judged worthy to receive Christ. But after her, we undoubtedly owe special gratitude and reverence to St. Joseph. In him, the Old Testament finds its fitting close. He brought the noble line of patriarchs and prophets to its promised fulfillment. What the divine goodness had offered as a promise to them, he held in his arms. Obviously, Christ does not now deny to Joseph that intimacy, reverence, and very high honor which he gave him on earth as a son to his father. Rather, we must say that in heaven, Christ completes and perfects all that he gave at Nazareth. Now we can see how the last summoning words of the Lord appropriately apply to St. Joseph. Enter into the joy of your Lord. In fact, although the joy of eternal happiness enters into the soul of a man, the Lord preferred to say to Joseph, enter into joy. His intention was that the word should have a hidden spiritual meaning for us. They convey not only that this holy man possesses an inward joy, but also that it surrounds him and engulfs him like an infinite abyss. Remember us, St. Joseph, and plead for us to your foster child. Ask your most holy bride, the Virgin Mary, to look kindly upon us, since she is the mother of him who with the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns eternally. Amen.